Hello everyone, and welcome to Cimquest 2-Minute Tuesdays. In today's episode, we will look at the high-speed Opti-Rough Toolpath. This toolpath removes large amounts of material faster and more efficiently using intelligent dynamic motion. To begin, I have already pre-selected a machine for our toolpath. I navigate to the toolpath tabs, and under the 3D gallery, I select the Opti-Rough Toolpath. The surface high-speed dialog box appears, prompting me to select my machine and geometry. I click Select Entities for Machining, which brings me back to the graphics window. I select my model, click End Selection, and set my wall and floor stock to desired amount. The next step is to set your toolpath control. I select the boundary, tool containment, set it from outside, and compensate to the center. I choose the tool I'm using and set my speeds and feeds accordingly. In the cut parameters page, we'll set our step over, step down, and we make sure to check the box step up. The step over is a radial mount of the tool. You can use a set distance amount or percentage of the tool diameter. The step down controls the maximum rough and depth. The dynamic motion in Opti-Rough allows us to take advantage of using as much of the end mill flute length as the machine, tooling, and fixturing can handle. First, Opti-Rough is controlled by dynamic motion. This ensures that the cutter is controlled by angle of engagement, just like its 2D equivalent. This creates predictable tool engagement, allowing you to rough with increased feeds and speeds without over-engagement of the material during your toolpath, where tool chipping, wearing, or even worse, breakage with traditional toolpaths. Step-up cuts is the second key component to Opti-Rough. This allows you to semi-finish the part using contour motion of the part's surface features between each dynamic motion pass to remove those areas of material. With other enhancements like tool collision, rest material, and inside-outside strategy, the Opti-Rough toolpath is a toolpath of choice for fast 3D metal removal. Well, that's it for today's episode of 2-Minute Tuesdays. Thank you for joining, and we'll see you next time.